Hi guys, and I hope you're all having a good day. Are you all excited for some more Mass Effect? Why are we? And we are standing in the right spot. This really confused me.
Glad to see you're okay, Commander.
And I'm glad to see you too, Caden. But you know what? We gotta go talk to Joker. If you guys don't remember last time we finished Eden Prime, you saw the cockroach people. Wearing glowing glue, green, glowy green, glow, green things are bad. God, can't speak today. Great day to record when you can't speak. And had a lovely chat with Anderson. Learned the pretty, not pretty bird is an evil, not pretty bird, and don't like people. But I don't blame them. People suck. Let's talk to Joker.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work.
Oh, doom. Man, it always reminded me of a giant flower or the weirdest. Funkiest eyeball, especially from angles like this.
Look at the size of that ship.
The Ascension, flagship of the Citadel fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Kinda
what
is.
I'm just saying, you need firepower too.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy. Requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower.
Aw. Joker, you're so pretty.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
Look at that beautiful ship. Such a beautiful ship. Fake sky.
This is an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony?
Would they?
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Seren? You can't just ignore a rogue specter. I demand action.
You don't get to make demands of a counter ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Dude,
just the ground team from Eden.
I walked by like 30 people.
I have.
There's four.
Reports. I assume they're accurate.
If you include Anderson.
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
He's dangerous.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead,
the babe.
Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not hers.
I'm pretty sure beacons have blown up before.
Turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
Yay! Asshole.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Good to know. But I want to know who in the right mind thought Udina would be a good person to have as an ambassador. He's a terrible ambassador. I'm sorry. whoever likes him, and I've never met anyone who does, but just in case. The man just demands things. He doesn't compromise, even though he's a politician for a foreign area. Ambassador. Man, I'm terrible with words this morning. How about not? But an ambassador's supposed to have their country's interests at heart. Come on, you can run. But still be able to compromise with the other countries. You know, to get either a stand-in or to push their own interests forward. Udina, I demand! You can't demand shit. Hey, it sounds like another politician that we all know and hate. Except Udina's more... Nope, they both look pretty orange with BioWare old school graphics. They both look pretty orange. It's being a bug. We'll ask about the bug.
Greetings, and welcome to the Presidium. My name is Avina, and I am pleased to be your virtual guide throughout this level of the Citadel Space Station.
No, thanks.
I don't need a guide.
Our records indicate this is your first time.
No, it's not.
A brief orientation session is customary. Please allow me to do my job.
I'm interested.
I'll pass.
I apologize if... Please do not disturb the keepers.
But I want to know what the keeper is. Look how adorable he is with this fat little mantis mouth. He's so tiny. Aww. Alright. Ashley, shut up. There are no animals here. Booty shot. Booty shot. And we'll give you a booty shot too. Nope. Agreed. Sorry, but why in the world would you trust a politician? No less a politician that doesn't know how to do his job. Like, I would have asked to send another Spectre, or not even a Spectre, just anyone to go check the findings. Bring Powell in for questioning. I would do that myself. But, if I was Odina. Like, just request someone to go there and check it out. You could prove or not. You should know what Saren's flagship goddamn looks like.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time.
That babe! You're also pretty.
Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Love you. You're the best. I love you.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Who were you just talking to?
That was Executor Palin, head of Citadel Security, my boss. He'll be presenting my findings on Saren to the Council.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. He's a secret. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
I love you. I love you, I'll come back for you, Garrus. Yeah, if you guys haven't figured out just by the comments on Nihilus earlier, Garrus, we're gonna romance Garrus. I don't care if you guys' companions don't like him or not, he's mine. I've romanced several people in my many three playthroughs. Honestly, the one with Garrus I feel is the most real. Or, not even real. I liked it the best. His reactions made sense.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
and I didn't feel bad. Like with Thane.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihilus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihilus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Why didn't you ask Saren where he was on those dates? And then check his logs. You can check his logs. You have the power to check his logs.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihilus gone, his files passed on to me.
Not that fast, they couldn't.
I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
Saren despises humanity. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
No.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue.
But no. And don't bring up dreams. That's just retarded.
How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
I do love the Council. Sorry, Counselor. I love her face markings.
And the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain.
Yes, it
you
was.
Saren have too much history.
That's the only smart thing you've done or said.
I know, Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race.
No.
Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Any idea where we could find him?
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with him.
So how does the Ambassador not know that, but the guy who hasn't been on the Citadel for like a month or two know that?
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Balavon's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience, no hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end the war without a second thought.
Innocence doesn't end wars, it causes them.
I know how the world works. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions, but only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
All right, let's go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the ambassador's office if you need anything else.
No, let's go find Harkin. Just because, as Femship, I do so love
that guy's up to something.
What I can do.
What? Oh, no, I wasn't. Never mind.
Oh, look at your little chin marking.
Yes, is there something you want? Why are you so interested in the keepers?
Keepers? I've got no interest in the keep.
Don't get coy.
Oh, hush you.
I'm not so sure I should be talking to you about this. Just tell me what you're doing. I'm not here to get you into trouble.
All right. I guess it wouldn't hurt to tell you.
Trouble.
I use a scanner to gather readings on the keepers. So far, I've had mixed results. I find it difficult to get near the creatures.
Why were you being so secretive about it, though?
Well, technically, we're not supposed to disturb the keepers. I don't really think my scanning disturbs them, but the authorities might disagree. I'd like to do it more openly, but it's not really worth getting arrested over.
I can help you out. I'm not worried about the authorities.
I don't even know who you are.
I'm Commander Shepard with the Alliance Military.
Well, biggest badass in the galaxy.
You'll need this. It's the scanning device I developed. Activate it each time you see a keeper. All collected data will automatically upload to my database. I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan.
I should get going then.
Yes, I have much work myself. So long. And good luck with the scanning.
I scan all the funny bugs. Come here, Mantis Men. Mantis Men. But the main reason the authorities say not to is because they explode. And if his scanning's not causing exploding, it's not really disturbing. So it's not illegal. Just odd. I think. Come on, Ashley. Button. Oh, my chair's breaking a little. Or there's a screw loose. Not sure. What evidence? Yep. That's why you're a jarhead. A stupid one of that. Da 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 da. Click. It's a big stupid jellyfish. Come on. Running in this game is so annoying. Cause sometimes it's just going for it. Other times you hold the button like 700 different times. You do. Let's go wards. Yes, that's where we want to go. But we would like to run. Button. Oh, I also need to go put on the new armored weapons I got.
Attack on for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
Eventually. Why don't they put it out there that it was a Prothean beacon that caused the attack? Oh yeah. Bug? If you guys are wondering why I know where they are, I've missed like four as we walk. But I think there's 23. There's always two or three that I just can't remember where they are.
Have blockaded the dig site, claiming that artifacts of the Enkindlers, as the Hanar call them, should not be disturbed. The excavation team has appealed to Hanar representatives on the Citadel to reach a diplomatic solution.
Man, loading scenes. There's a lot of me jumping through loading screens on elevators. I might skip some of them. Yes, I see that, but I want to run.
Excuse me, Commander Shepard!
Yeah, okay.
I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
Yeah, sure, why not?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
How do you know I'm investigating anything?
Sounds like a good cause. If I find any information, it's yours.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
Oh, I'm a little tired. Continue walking. God, 90% of this episode is just me walking and muttering and talking. So much talking. Man, I understand that problem now. There's always that one customer who thinks he bought it here, didn't buy it here, and has no proof they bought it here, and they just want the money. 90% of the time it's stolen. Conrad!
You're Commander Shepard, the hero of Eden Prime. I am so honored to meet you.
Nice to meet you. And you are?
My name is Conrad. Conrad Werner. They say you killed more than 100 Geth on Eden Prime.
They say a lot of things. I was too busy killing them to count.
Hey,
I think it was more like 20,
busy, but,
maybe 30.
Do you have time for a quick autograph?
Sure.
Anything for a fan. Here.
And that's how you be a
Thanks.
Good celebrity.
I really appreciate it. My wife is going to be so impressed. I'll let you get back to work. Oh, but next time you're on Earth, I'd love to buy you a drink. Thanks again.
See, that kind of fan, that's the best kind of fan right there. They're just like, they get excited, they say something about you, ask for your autograph, and leave. Maybe ask for a hug. Because I've done that. And if they're awkward about it and say no, and I'm just like, okay. But if they're willing to give hugs, why not? Saving? That means something bad's gonna happen. Like that. Hey, friend. Wait a minute. What is with this game giving me pistols? Shield boost. I think he's stuck. There we go. Grenade? Kinda worked. And he has a rocket launcher. Why can't I have a rocket launcher? There we go. No!